So the president, over a couple of days ago,
yeah,
he's literally, for the very first time, he's told his deputy, look, if you're not happy, quit, resign.
Yes.
You know, just walk away.
It was a little bit strange, but not surprising, because he created that condition himself. For 4 years, the president tried to frustrate his deputy for him to resign. It started by taking away the responsibility. First, you remember the jibe that telling the deputy president, hii kijana anapenda kutanga-tanga.
Kutanga-tanga,
yes. You remember even Mombasa, they were launching a project. And then the president says, you know, we must take lifestyle audit because some people, all that kind of thing. Of course, the deputy president immediately the next 2 days said he welcomes lifestyle audit and let the structures be put in place. When the deputy president says, okay, that subject, you know, collapsed, then it moved to executive order number one of 2019, which put all the responsibilities of the deputy president in the office of the cabinet secretary, my friend C.S. Matiang'i, and the P.S. Kibicho, and you know, all that, all those stories, they were hoping, or it was intended. You remember, they even closed an office, the office that was being built in Mombasa for the deputy president. I hear, by the way, that his personal belongings are still locked inside.
He still has his clothes there.
Yes. So all these frustrations, for those of us who have worked closely with the president and the deputy, would see that there was a problem. It's only that nobody was willing to voice it. What is strange is that the constitution gives the responsibility or functions of the deputy president to deputize the president in his functions and to perform functions that are delegated to him by the president or by an act of parliament. It is strange because there is no, I would have wished if I was in that interview, to ask the president only one question, which I wish my friend Gashuri and the team had asked. What responsibility did you give your deputy president and refuse to perform? Or what responsibility of government given the deputy president? Because, you know, the deputy president, like deputy governors, cannot allocate themselves responsibilities. They depend on their bosses. And in some jurisdictions, you become, you know, a newspaper pusher. In other jurisdictions, you have, because of civility that goes with the office and the way you campaign together, you get to perform your functions. A very good example in the recent past is the relationship between Obama and Biden, which was a very cordial, nice relationship, friends beyond. You remember when Obama was about to retire, he bestowed upon Biden the highest Medal of Honor, you know, all that kind of relationship. And if you see Ruto and Uhuru in first term, you would have likened them with Obama and Biden.
Yeah.
But if you see them in the second term, you can almost be very clear that the relationship was not as it was in the first term.
Okay, so which to
close that, just that yes. part. So the president, to his own credit, has not accused the deputy president of failing a single responsibility. He's only accusing him of unhappiness.
Okay,
because
I agree, but let me ask you this.
Just to conclude that sentence, because it's one part.
Okay.
There's only one thing that the president complained about his deputy. He complains about the BBI process, which we all know, BBI, it was not a government program discussed in any cabinet or passed as part of Jubilee Manifesto, or was there even any involvement of the deputy president in amending the constitution?